Welcome to Wake Up with God. We live stream daily mass today. We attend the Holy Mass on Thursday, 16th May 2024. Thursday of the seventh week of Eastertide. With them in you and you and you and me, may they be so completely one that the world will realize that it was you who sent me, says the Lord. Please keep quiet and concentrate on attending the Mass.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today is the feast, or the memorial of Saint Isidore, or San Isidro Labrador. So many chapels and even churches are celebrating their feast with his intercessor. Intercession that we pray for our farmers, especially who are having a hard time in this climate change, that they may, like Saint Isidore, may receive the blessing of God. Saint Isidore is the patron saint of the farmers and the good example that Saint Isidore leaves for us all is the balancing of prayer and work. May this be our way also of obtaining this practice in our personal life. Brothers and sisters, to be worthy of this celebration, let us recall to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God of mercy on us forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, to whom belongs all creation and all who call us and who call us to serve you by caring for the gifts that surround us. Inspire us by the power of Saint Isidore to share our food with the hungry and to work for the salvation of all people. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. At Miletus, Paul spoke to the presbyters of the church of Ephesus. Keep watch over yourselves and over the whole flock, of which the Holy Spirit has appointed you overseers, in which you tend the church of God, that he acquired with his own blood. I know that after my departure, savage wolves will come among you, and they will not spare the flock. And from your own group, men will come forward, perverting the truth, to draw the disciples away after them. So be vigilant and remember that for 3 years, night and day, I unceasingly admonish each of you with tears. And now I commend you to God and to that gracious word of His that can build you up and give you the inheritance among all who are consecrated. I have never wanted anyone's silver or gold or clothing. You know well that these very hands have served my needs and my companions. In every way, I have shown you that by hard work of that sort, we must help the weak. And keep in mind the words of the Lord Jesus, who himself said, "It is more blessed to give than to receive." When he had finished speaking, he knelt down and prayed with them all. They were all weeping loudly as they threw their arms around Paul and kissed him. For they were deeply distressed that he had said that they would never see his face again. Then they escorted him to the ship. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Show forth, O God, your power, the power, O God, with which you took our part. For your temple in Jerusalem, let the kings bring you gifts.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
You kingdoms of the earth, sing to God. Chant praise to the Lord, who rides on the heights of the ancient heavens. Behold, his voice resounds, the voice of power. Confess the power of God.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Over Israel is his majesty. His power is in the skies. Awesome in his sanctuary is God, the God of Israel. He gives power and strength to his people.
Sing to God, O kingdoms of the earth.
Your word, O Lord, is truth. Consecrate us in the truth.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Lifting up his eyes to heaven, Jesus prayed, saying, Holy Father, keep them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one, just as we are one. When I was with them, I protected them in your name that you gave me. And I guarded them, and none of them was lost except the son of destruction, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you. I speak this in the world so that they may share my joy completely. I gave them your word, and the world hated them, because they do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. I do not ask that you take them out of the world, but that you keep them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world any more than I belong to the world. Consecrate them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, so I sent them into the world. And I consecrate myself for them, so that they also may be consecrated in truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Since I stayed in Bicol, in Naga, for 4 years prior to my assignment here in Makati, I remember during this time, specifically today, May 15, there are 3 chapels in our parish, in Our Lady of Mount Carmel, that celebrate the San Isidro as their chapel patron saint, because our place in Bicol is a rural parish, and there are also a good number of farmers within the area. And Saint Isidore was born in the 11th century and had lived more or less a little more than 50 years. He had been married to to also a saintly person, to his wife, Maria della Cabeza Toribia, and they had one son, and it had been narrated that there was one instance that this son of theirs fell in a well, and miraculously there was water that brought up this child for his own safety. And Saint Isidore is a patron saint of the farmers and also of rural communities. A very poor person, a hired worker, yet very devout. He would never go to the field unless he was able to attend the Eucharist or the Mass. So he would usually attend Mass as at one of the churches in Madrid, in Spain. And some miracles have been told that one day his fellow farm workers complained to their master that Isidore was always late for work in the morning. And upon investigation, the master found Isidore at prayer while an angel was doing the plowing for him. And then on another occasion, another miracle, his master saw an angel plowing on either side of him so that Isidore's work was equal to that of three of his fellow field workers. Imagine the master of the field was seeing three individuals, Isidore and the two angels plowing together with him. And that was really equal to that of the three of his fellow field workers. Isidore is also said to have brought back to life his master's deceased daughter, and to have caused a fountain of fresh water to burst from the dry earth and to quench his master's thirst. Miracles are accounted with this or to this saintly person Isidore. And then another thing was on a one snowy day when going to the mill with wheat to be ground, and Isidore passed a flock of wood pigeons scratching vainly for food on the hard surface of the frosty ground. And taking pity on the poor animals, Isidore poured half of his sack of precious wheat upon the ground for the birds, despite the mocking of witnesses. And when he reached the mill, the bag was full, and the wheat, when it was ground, produced double the expected amount of flour. And then another account, Isidore's wife, Maria, always kept a pot of stew on the fireplace in their humble home, as Isidore would often bring home anyone who was hungry. And one day he brought home more hungry people than usual. And after the wife served many of them, Maria told him that there simply was no more stew in the pot. And he insisted that she check the pot again, and she was able to spoon out enough stew to feed them. Parang multiplication of food or soup. And on April 2, 1212, after torrential rains had exhumed cadavers from cemeteries in Madrid, his body was discovered in an apparent state of incorruptibility. He is said to have appeared also to Alfonso VIII of Castile, and to have shown him the hidden path by which he surprised the Moors and gained the victory of Las Navas de Tolosa in 1212. So there has been a number of miracles attributed to Isidore and has been counted as 438. Ang dami palang mga pangyayari, milagro. And the only original source of these accounts is a 14th century codex in a book which relates the five of his miracles and particularly the pigeons and the grain, which we have just narrated. The angels also plowing, we also have mentioned this. And the saving of his donkey through prayer from a wolf attack. And the account of his wife's pot of food, as we have said a while ago. And a similar account of his feeding the brotherhood. How wonderful when a person would really dedicate himself to God and to his works, that God can really instrumentalize the person for the spread of his kingdom. Today, as we have also listened to the readings, both would express to us the kind of a farewell speech or farewell prayer. St. Paul, as we have read a while ago, wherein as he would have his last visit to the church of Ephesus, and he wanted the shepherds to be faithful to God and to be generous in their service, to make initiatives, especially in preaching the word of God. He wanted that they continued spread the good news and the good works among the people or the community they are in. And as it has been said here, when Paul had finished speaking, he knelt down and prayed with them all. They were all weeping loudly as they threw their arms around Paul and kissed him, for they were really distressed that he had said that they would never see his face again. The farewell message of St. Paul to the Church of Ephesus. And in the Gospel, we have also a similar farewell message or even prayer of the Lord. When he was lifting his eyes to heaven, Jesus praying to the Father to keep his disciples in his name and that to protect them and to guard them and also to speak or to lead them to the truth, consecrate them in the truth as Jesus had prayed. May this farewell message and prayer be actualized in our daily personal life as we have this prayer even true for ourselves. The Lord continues to abide in us and to journey with us, to guide us. May this prayer be felt by all of us as the Lord loves his people, loves his servants, his disciples. Let us all together pray the Oratio Imperata ad petendam pluviam. God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, and of all the wondrous elements of nature that sustain your living creatures, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that beset your people at this time, disrupting their activities and threatening their lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. At your command, the wind and the seas obey. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures, so that your people can engage in productive undertakings and our young people can pursue learning in tranquility and comfort. Merciful and generous God, open our eyes to the richness and beauty of your creation, and instill in us a deep love for this earth and all that is in and around it. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly and protect them from abuse and exploitation. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother, to intercede for us for the protection of our land and our people whom she loves. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Through the present oblation, O Lord, which we offer in commemoration of blessed Saint Isidore Labrador, bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are praised in the company of your saints, and in crowning with their merits, you crown your own gifts. By their way of life, you offer us an example. By communion with them, you give us companionship. By their intercession, sure support, so that encouraged by so great a cloud of witnesses, we may run as victors in the race before us and win with them the imperishable crown of glory through Christ our Lord. And so with the angels and archangels and with the great multitude of the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, San Isidro Labrador, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray for our poor farmers and their families. We now pray in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is Jesus, our life, our food and strength. Happy are we who come to receive him in this meal.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Mm-hmm.
Let us pray. May the sacrament we have received, O Lord, in commemoration of Lent of beloved Saint Isidore, sanctify our minds and hearts, that we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Sa Don Bosco, masaya.
Sama-sama. Novena to our Mother of Perpetual Help. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brothers and sisters, as children of our Blessed Mother, we are gathered before her miraculous picture to honor her and to pray for all our needs. And worthy children that we are, let us first of all ask God's mercy and pardon. Merciful Father, you sent your divine Son to redeem us by his death and resurrection and to give us new life. By this you make us your children, to love one another in Christ. How many times in the past we have forgotten the sublime dignity. We have sinned against our brothers and sisters. We have offended you. Merciful Father, forgive us. Repenting sincerely of our sins, we ask your mercy. May we always live as your truly devoted children. Novena Prayer. Dear Mother of Perpetual Help, from the cross Jesus gave you to us for our mother. You are the kindest, the most loving of all mothers. Look tenderly on us, your children, as we now ask you to help us in all our needs, especially this one. While you were on earth, dear Mother, you willingly shared in the sufferings of your Son. Strengthened by your faith and confidence in the fatherly love of God, you accepted the mysterious designs of His will. We too have our crosses and trials. Sometimes they almost crush us to the ground. Dearest Mother, share with us your abundant faith and confidence in God. Make us aware that God never ceases to love us, that He answers all our prayers in the way that is best for us. Strengthen our hearts to carry the cross in the footsteps of your divine Son. Help us to realize that he who shares the cross of Christ will certainly share his resurrection. Dearest Mother, As we worry about our own problems, let us not forget the needs of others. You always loved others so much. Help us to do the same. While praying for our own intentions and for the intentions of all here present at this novena, we earnestly ask you, our Mother, to help us comfort the sick and the dying. Give hope to the poor and the unemployed. Heal the brokenhearted. Walk in solidarity with the oppressed. Teach justice to their oppressors. And bring back to God all those who have offended Him. Dearest Mother, help us to avoid sin which separates us from our Heavenly Father and from one another. Full of trust in you, we place ourselves under the mantle of your maternal protection and confidently hope for your compassionate intercession. Amen. Prayer for the home. Mother of perpetual help, we choose you as queen of our homes. We ask you to bless all our families with your tender motherly love. May the sacrament of marriage bind husbands and wives so closely together that they will always be faithful to each other and love one another as Christ loves His church. We ask you to bless all parents. May they love and cherish the children whom God has entrusted to them. May they always give them the example of a truly Christian life. Help them to bring up their children in the love and fear of God. Bless all children that they may love, honor, and obey their fathers and mothers. To your loving care, we especially entrust the youth of today. Give us all a sense of responsibility that we may do our part in making our home a haven of peace, like your own home at Nazareth. We take you as our model. Help us to grow daily in genuine love of God and neighbor so that justice and peace may happily reign in the entire family of mankind. Amen. Petitions to our Mother of Perpetual Help. Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin conceived without sin,
pray for us.
Our Mother of Perpetual Help,
pray for us.
We sinners call to you.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may rejoice with you at Christ's victory over sin and death.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be filled with the Holy Spirit and become courageous witnesses of Christ's love for men.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be more and more like our Divine Lord as you were.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be meek and humble of heart like your Son, Jesus.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may fear losing God's friendship forever by unrepented sin.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may seek Christ's mercy and forgiveness constantly in the sacrament of penance.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be aware of God speaking to us in the events of daily life.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may pray daily with love and trust, especially in moments of temptation.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may understand the value of worshiping God together in the Eucharist.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may grow in the love of Christ and neighbor by frequent communion.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may reverence our bodies as temples of the Holy Spirit.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may strive to be true Christian by our loving concern for others.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may proclaim the dignity of work by doing our own work conscientiously.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may forgive from our heart those who have wronged us.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may see the evil of seeking our own interests at the expense of others.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may work for the just distribution of this world's goods.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may share our talents with others for the good of the community.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may accept our responsibility in the community in the spirit of genuine service.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That the Holy Spirit may guide and strengthen Pope Francis, the bishops, and the clergy.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be blessed with an increase of priestly and religious vocations.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
that we may care and protect God's creation.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may defend the human dignity and sanctity of human life from conception to natural death.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That there will be genuine and lasting peace in the world.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may bring the knowledge and love of Christ to those who do not know Him.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be aware of our dependence on God in the midst of human achievements.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be ready at death to enter the home of our Heavenly Father.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That we may be comforted at the death of our dear ones by our hope in the risen Lord.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
That our departed brothers and sisters quickly share in your Son's resurrection.
Loving Mother, pray for us.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions. Holy Mary, pray for us. Pray for all the people of God. May all experience God's perpetual help. Lord, you gave us Mary to be our mother, ever ready to help us. Grant us the grace to have recourse to her in all our needs. Amen. Thanksgiving prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, truly present in the most blessed Eucharist, we adore you. It has pleased the Father that in you all his fullness should dwell, and that through you he should reconcile all things to himself. Grant us the grace to be truly grateful for all that our Father has done for us. Grant that we may be truly sorry for our sins and renew our lives. Through you we thank the Eternal Father for the gift of life. He has created all the wonderful things of this world for us. May we learn to use them well, so that through them we may grow in love for Him. Above all, we thank our Father for sending you to us as the greatest expression of His love, to save us in all creation by your death and resurrection. We thank you, Lord, for giving us your own Mother to be our Mother of perpetual help. May the countless favors we have received through her intercession, and especially through the novena, inspire us with greater confidence in God's loving mercy and perpetual help. Grant that we may always do the holy will of God and persevere in His love. To the Most Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be honor, glory, and thanksgiving forever and ever. Amen. Prayer for the sick. Lord Jesus Christ, you bore our sufferings and carried our sorrows in order to show us clearly the value of human weakness and patience. Graciously hear our prayer for the sick, especially. Grant that they who are weighed down with pain and other affliction of illness may experience God's healing power and comfort. Restore them to health in body and soul, so that they can continue to serve you and their brothers and sisters. Amen.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.